Excellent morning, Nigeria. It's a brand new week, and it's time for us to bring you another exciting edition of Wake Up Nigeria.
It's time for us to wake up. That's what he means.
Wake up.
Yes, wake up. The biggest, in fact, you know what, feel-good show that you've ever seen right here on terrestrial TV. We love you guys, and of course, we know that waking you up in the morning is, you know, we do this so well.
Yeah.
We do it so well that people don't have anywhere else to tune to. We're here to usher in a brand new week. And of course, just in case you were wondering my name, my name is Titilayo Oyinsan.
And I'm Yomi Owope. And we also like to know that you tuned in to be a part of what we have to offer today.
Yes, indeed.
And it's going to be really, really exciting.
Make sure you don't forget, we're live online at tvcontinental.tv and on Facebook at TVC Connect. Connect with us, comment. Do everything you can online. Put the hashtag right there, Wake Up Nigeria, for Twitter, Facebook, Instagram.
Guess what?
Yeah.
Something is always happening in the kitchen.
Something especially special today.
Well, something unexpected. You're going to see Mike Messicano.
Yes, indeed.
In the kitchen.
He's back, people.
I'm back. Yes. And I will chef for fair in the house. Let's go.
Yes.
Are we fighting?
We're fighting.
What are these?
I don't know which security guard allowed Mike to enter the gate.
Okay, so I think I'm noticing a pot belly.
What? A pot belly? What?
Mike's belly is coming out.
Why?
Yummy, move on. I can't breathe again.
It's getting fat.
But it's great to be back, of course. It's great to be back.
Yeah, it's great to see you, man.
He deserved that rest, though.
Yeah.
He did, you know, all this energy. Well, don't worry.
It's time for me to take some time off as well.
Really? Yummy?
I already asked.
Don't do this to me.
They said I'm going to leave you with Mike. No. You're in capable hands.
Please, should I kneel down? Okay, I'm wearing a very light-colored dress. I won't do that, but please,
All right, let's go straight to this morning's highlights. To motivate us to make the best of the various waiting periods that we ultimately experience in life, Stephen Omojube is back with us. We're excited, and he's going to be talking to us about this this Monday morning.
Yes, indeed. And if you've ever wondered about what VConnect has to offer, we have a couple of people joining us once again to enlighten us on that company.
And you know that music is a big part of what we offer here on the show. Afropop artist B Tasha is our star this morning, bringing us a live performance.
And then it's on to MM. She'll be showing us multiple ways to use our plastic bottles at home. There are always so many plastic bottles around these days. I don't know. I really need this particular one.
And because it's Monday, you know we'll be taking a trip down memory lane in this week in history segment as we bring you notable events from way back.
Yes, indeed. And finally, Nigerian OAP actress and writer Oreka Goddess will be joining us for a chat much later on the show.
Oh, for the love of God, please let me through!
Jaddy, please wait. Are you going to let me talk to you? It was all a misunderstanding, Jaddy.
Misunderstanding?
Yes.
That's not what Chioma said.
Now forget Chioma, man.
Forget her?
Forget that goody two-shoes. She doesn't know what to
say. Yay.
Wow. Monday! Okay, so I've missed being able to do this.
Don't do that.
I should not. Welcome back, Mike.
What's wrong with the two of you?
Mike doesn't like being rough handled. He doesn't like
being rough handled. There has not been a chance to hit anybody on my left for any reason. Why? It's a welcoming committee.
It's so good to have you back, Mike.
It's supposed to be welcome back. Like,
Mike.
Welcome back,
on
Mike.
The wall. You understand? On the wall.
It's not that deep.
Cake.
It's not that deep.
Because of this one, it is too razz.
Unless, Mike. Mike,
it's too razz.
Mike, unless you were the one that went to beat Serena Williams, there's not going to be any.
There should be something like that. And it is going all. I mean, this is too razz.
We need
friends that will be pouring us money and not water. I'll just get you. That's what it is. Also, kind of friends that is already they'll be pouring you water.
Sorry,
or
don't
drink
worry.
Or something.
Next time, there'll be balloons weekend, guys? And cake ready
good,
for you.
Good, good, good. Yeah, First and foremost, looks like you guys spent the whole weekend doing your hair.
Okay.
How many hours on yours?
How many hours?
Okay, so I think 6 hours.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, making my hair. Oh. You know, when I walked into the salon, the guy was like, oh, I'm going to be done in 3 hours. And I just looked at him.
Right.
Guy, you have no idea. Have you seen this hair?
Yeah.
And yeah, so he's a young guy. I mean, admire young guys who actually really push themselves. This guy actually, he relocated from Port Harcourt just to pursue his dream. of hairdressing, hairstyling. I mean, it's amazing. I even had to pay him more than I was supposed to just to encourage him.
Wow. Wow.
It's really nice.
But this looks nice, amazing. It's nice. But you see, this is the same thing I was saying. We are too much in Lagos. We are relocate to Lagos. We
are did you not relocate from Port Harcourt?
Did you not relocate? Exactly.
I thought about it. Over, while I was away, we were over 22 million in Lagos. Mm. Lagos alone is one-tenth of the whole nation.
Of the whole, yeah.
By 2050, the way we're going will be equal with tonight, we'll be equal with the rest of the country. Yes. At the rate we are going. So there has to be something. We have to decrease. We are too much.
There are actually a lot of places in Lagos that you won't even know their communities. Like, you just be driving, you'll be like, wait, there's a place here. People live here. You know, it's weird.
There's something that happened over the weekend with Serena Williams that I want us to talk about.
I think let's talk about the second one.
Yeah. So, it's because I really want to get you guys' opinion.
Sure.
Yeah, all right.
Welcome back. It's time for the newspaper headlines this Monday morning. We're starting with The Guardian.
Yes, indeed. And the headline is, airlines fortunes soar. Operators procure multi-billion naira aircraft. Banks woo sector players with 10% interest rates. Experts warns on outright purchase of airplanes. Wonder why the warning, though.
Yeah.
It also says here, Atiku Mark, insincere on restructuring, says APC. Both failed to act when they had the opportunity, it says. And it also says here, Nigeria, a journey through my identity. On page 18, more about that. Buhari, not against e-voting, says presidency. Consumers lament as DSTV defies court order, continues with new tariff. That's what we have on the cover of The Guardian.
All right, and the next is The Nation. 2019, APC, PDP fight over fake presidential aspirants. Name planted aspirants, party tells Wike. Now restructuring, Atiku, Mark under fire. APC, ex-vice president, others seeking gains. NSE to sanction 7 banks, 21 firms. Failure to file reports cited. FIRS to probe 6,700 billionaires. Wow, that's a large number. Quadri wins first ITTF title. 296 billion naira lost in 15,000 deals. And finally, South Sudan crash kills 19. All on the cover of The Nation.
The New Telegraph is next. It says here, governors move against senators. And there's quite a long list of governors here that are fighting for senatorial seats. It also says here, APC lawmakers mull defection to PDP, ADC and APGA. Was that APGA?
Yeah.
Yeah, it also says here, 19 states defy Oshomole, opt for indirect primaries. Ekweazu, orgy free to join APC, says Abia Chair. It also says here, 2019, Atiku consults Southern Middle Belt leaders, lists restructuring, unity, economy, security as priorities. Then I'll wrap this up by reading this one. It says, NAMA to shut airports over 4 billion naira debt, airlines to divert flights. Wow. Okay,
all right, and
so
then we have the Daily Sun here, and the headline, APC mulls restructuring, federal government to implement El Rufai panel report. A ruling party plays politics with it, says PDP. Buhari, APC sponsoring some PDP presidential aspirants, says Wike. And your party imploding, we've chased out moles, says the ruling party. Federal government plots to peg states' cash withdrawal at 20 million monthly. Biafra. IPOB alleges another invasion of Kanu's home. And finally, 2019, Afenifere, Pandef, Ohanaeze, Middle Belt Forum to meet Buhari, others. All on the cover of the Daily Sun.
And that's all we have time for on the newspaper headlines for this morning.
Of course, fit buddy is a healthy buddy. Yes, now let's get to The Guardian, where there's a fitness routine for us already.
A very good morning to you, viewers. Welcome to the fitness segment of your favorite show on TV, Wake Up Nigeria. So my name is Benjamin, and today I'm going to be taking you through the fitness routine we have for today. So it's such a Monday morning, wet, and certainly we'll be able to shake it off, and get enough energy flowing through us. So today I'm starting with stretching exercises, and there are 7 exercises that will totally work your muscles. So let's go this way. You take it up, you move to the right, and to the left. Stretch your shoulders. And the other side. Then your thighs. Move to the other side. Then we go this way. This way also. Then if you can, you stretch your thighs. You go this way. Then the other side. And that's it. So first of all, we are starting with the squats, the squatting exercises. So we're going this way, 25. If you can't go 20, that's fine. So let's go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. That's it for the squats. So you can do the squats, you can do this 15 reps of 4 to 5 sets. So the next move we are going is what works the upper body, a very good compound exercise for your upper body, and that is the standard push-up. So we're going this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So that's the second move. You can do this 10 reps, 10 to 15 reps of 4 sets. So the next move we're gonna be doing is the mountain climber. So the mountain climber, we're going this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So that's the third exercise, the mountain climber. The next move we're gonna be doing is the burpees. So the burpees is a sure good exercise that will get you challenging. So we're going this way. 1, 2, to 15. That's it for the burpees. So the next move, and probably as time will permit, the last move is the jumping jack. So we'll go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So that's it, time could permit. But I hope by the time you do this correctly, it's sure to get you moving.
After workout, you know how it is. We get to the kitchen, and then I have to tell you that the main reason I was away was to go sharpen my culinary skills.
Really?
Yeah.
So you want to take work for my hands now?
On everything. Okay, of course, but then Chef Ofe is here. She is the boss. I'm just a sous chef for today. And what do we have this morning?
Okay, this morning we have pasta with shrimp and snail sauce with a simple slaw.
Oh, now, there's no better day for me to be in the kitchen. I love snails. I love snails. But then look at the menu out there. We have a macaroni. We have, okay, macaroni is the pasta,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah, that's the pasta.
Yep. There's shrimps, there's snail, pepper, onions, there's cabbage, eggs, carrots, eggs, mayonnaise, seasoning cubes, spices, and parsley. Not like I know what parsley is anyway. Which one is parsley, please?
That one.
Okay, what about you? But then, that's what you can see there. This is parsley.
Yes.
Okay, this grass I normally eat.
It's nah, not grass. It's not grass.
It's grass now.
It's garnish.
It's garnish. Okay, so this is a full man, 3x4. Ah, see, formation.
Yeah,
it's even more than team plus coach. Ah, nice one. All right, so let's get to it.
Okay.
What's the first thing that we do?
We'd make the sauce first.
Okay.
To start that, I would start by frying the shrimps in oil.
Oh, okay.
It's been pre-salted. Just
pre-salted.
Lightly salted.
Did you take off the...
Yes.
Okay, so there's always the outer...
Yes.
Yes. I'm not really a fan of seafood, but I know I can manage shrimps.
Don't worry, I'll convert you today.
Hey, I'm converted already.
I'll convert you today.
Wow, I love the sound this makes and all of that. Okay, so we're putting everything inside. Yes, yes. How long will this fry for?
Let's say five minutes or less than, depends on how hot the oil.
Okay, yes. Now for this sauce, are we going to deep fry it or is it going to be light fry?
Deep
fry, yes. Right?
Yeah, okay, so we're working with time here, so,
okay.
So we need to be very fast.
Okay, so we're going to ensure that, well, if it's fried, then I love it when stuff is fried. I know a lot of people would tell you that, hey, come on, fried stuff, which is true.
Yeah,
but,
well,
hey,
true.
I love fried stuff.
Once in a while, doesn't
Yeah, it doesn't
you.
Hurt.
Yep.
It doesn't hurt, man, once in a while. Okay, so while that is going on, the other preparations, what else are we going to be doing here?
Okay, so once I take the shrimps out, I'm going to start frying this pepper sauce.
Oh, okay.
It's made up of tomatoes, tatashe, and pepper. And I'll put in a little bit of tomato paste.
Okay, so this one color. Is fresh tomatoes.
Yeah, this is fresh tomatoes. All right. This tinned.
Okay, this is. All right, cool. And then, of course, that's where the onions. The egg, we didn't mention. Where's the egg coming
for
in?
For the slaw.
Oh.
Like a garnish.
Okay, like a garnish. So
yes.
You just put it on top and
yes.
all of that. And
yes.
then what?
That's the dressing for the slaw. It's made of. calm down. It's made of mayonnaise. Salad, cream, and barbecue sauce. The barbecue sauce was just to make it a little bit sweet.
Is this the only breakfast? Because from what I'm seeing here now, this is breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
You eat it and close shop for the day.
This is breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Don't look at this one. Don't look at it. Yeah, that's my favorite. She doesn't want to talk about it yet. Let's leave that one. That's the final one.
Yes.
That's a snail there. But then, hey, come on. I love snails.
Me too.
Much more than I love seafood. But then, of course, seafood is quite very healthy.
Yes,
yeah.
It is.
You know, shrimps, prawns, crabs. Have you ever done with crabs before?
Yes. I use crab a lot in seafood okra.
Whoa.
Yes.
And it with the exoskeleton, the shell and all of
that. Yes. No, they open it up, then break off the legs.
I see those things, man. I see it in movies. I've never tried it. I don't think I would. But hey, come on, that would make for a very wonderful date or something. All right, so we're still here. There's still more to come from the kitchen, but then we have to take a short break now. Don't go anywhere. It's still Wake Up Nigeria. Welcome back to the best part of Wake Up Nigeria. And of course, Chef Ofe is in the house. Now, while they were away, what have we done?
I fried the shrimps, I'm frying the snails.
Okay, so now we're taking the snails now. Is there? The shrimps is done, if you can see it here. So we're ready. And now I told earlier, I was thinking that when you said deep fried, it was going to be maybe brownish.
No. If you're going to eat it as just a side, with not putting it in the sauce, you could let it get to that extent.
To
but
that
since
extent.
I'm going to put it in the sauce.
In the sauce.
Yeah, still going to make it a bit moist. So.
Okay, well, that means I won't have that crunchy feel.
No, you wouldn't.
I wouldn't have. Okay,
so. Yeah, so which one don't you like, the crunchy feel?
I love the crunchy. Anything crunchy is, crunchy does it for me. She does it for me. Okay, so the snails now, and then how long do we need to fry this?
I can take it out in another 2 minutes.
Was it boiled before?
Yes, it was.
It was
pre-boiled, yeah.
Okay, but now the frying etiquette and all of that, do you have to boil per boil before you fry?
I would love to, because I wouldn't want to take chances and have something undercooked.
True. And then when you per boil, that's when you have a chance for the ingredients to get
go
into,
in, yeah.
into the
Yes,
the
and for something like snail, no matter how much you wash it with alum or lime, it's still a little bit slimy.
So, You know what happens? Growing up, we used to have we used to grow some food. We eat. We had water leaves. We had plantain and all that.
Yeah.
So there used to be snails around, and I learned how to prepare snails. That's why I love snails and all of that. So sometimes we use that alum or limestone. And then sometimes we even use a gari. Like,
yeah, I've heard that, but I haven't tried it.
Ah, when there's no alum, you tried it. Tell me what you use the gari and pa.
But that would be like waste. Now, gari that you can drink.
There's always gari. Gari cannot be wasted.
Well, true.
There's always gari. You know, so that was how. But then, snail is lovely. And then I know there's some people that don't like snail. If you don't like snail, I feel sorry for
you. Like, say you don't like dodo. I can't relate.
There's somebody in this life that does not like dodo.
I can't relate.
No. You are in this life. You don't like dodo.
I just can't. I can't relate.
When something happens, that really okay. But I think Dodo is even distant. Snail is okay. I think Dodo is even distant. But Dodo, don't try it. How can you not? We're not hunting Dodo today.
Yeah.
But then it's snails and all of that. So once this is ready, what next?
I'll start frying the sauce, the pepper sauce.
Okay, the pepper sauce.
Yeah, this one I blended it roughly.
Okay.
Then I pre-boiled it to drain out the water.
Was there any reason why you made it rough blending? Why it's not smooth?
Just for that particular sauce, it needs to be rough. Because if it's too thick or paste-like, I don't know how to... It's better when it's rough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Because of the pasta.
I like that. Yeah. I like that. Okay, so we need to let them know so that when they don't see, they know what happens after.
Yes.
So the sauce, what goes into the sauce here?
The shrimps and the snail.
Okay. Yeah. Are you sure that's that going on? You need some help. You need some help with this.
Don't take anyone.
I'm very good at this.
Don't take anyone.
You just surprised. There's only one I'll remember. Why was he just right here? It's just the only one I mean. Come on, man. I was away for 2 weeks. Well, this is what I went to learn. I went to brush up my skills. By the time I'm done with this frying, man.
Are you sure you didn't learn how to go and eat more?
Ah.
I think so.
Both of them all join. But this looks this is coming up real good. And I love the other. I love the aroma. Yeah. It's not aroma.
Although it's foul smelling.
Okay, so what goes into, while we're getting this, what goes into the sauce?
This sauce, yeah, the shrimps and the snail.
So snail.
Yeah, so after frying the snail, we take it out, put in the onions, put in this pepper mix.
Okay.
When this pepper mix dries up a little, we put in the tomato paste.
The tomatoes, okay.
The tomato paste is just for color, to make it red.
To make it red?
Yeah, it looks very appealing in the eye.
Just to make it red.
Yeah, to make it red.
Ah, we would have put color if it's only that one.
No.
If it's
so
just
when
to make
that
it red.
Is done, we'll now put in our meat stock.
This okay. Is beef. This and then beef. We also have seasoning cubes.
Yes,
here.
Seasoning cube, Mr. Chef.
Mr. Chef,
cube.
Okay.
Yeah, then we have curry, we have white pepper, we have
this?
Salt. This white pepper.
White pepper, I've never seen that before. Yeah. There's black pepper.
Yeah, there's black
right?
pepper, there's white pepper, there's Cameroon pepper, there's chili pepper.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, you need to give me some chance because while you're watching, it's going to be hard to taste this. We have skills of taking this out, eh? But then, hey, come on, we're still working here. But then, let's head over, of course, to Yomi, who is on standby with Vishal of VConnect. Of course, they have quite a lot in store for us. Over time, we've been, you know, telling you how to use that service, VConnect, and all of that. But then, hey, come on, we'll still have that. Now, that will be after Titi takes on Stevie in Omojibe, and they have a topic. I always look forward to this one. Titi, what do you have for us this morning?
Okay, Mike, I won't exactly be taking him on anything, I have to say. In fact, it's been a while that you've been around.
Yeah.
How have you been?
It's been very well, thank you.
Welcome back to the studio. Welcome back. So, Stephen Omojuigbe is a life coach, and ultimately in life, we're always waiting for or expectant of something. You know, something great to happen, something good to happen. And that period of waiting can be kind of tough, especially, you know, in situations, for instance, where a woman is waiting to get pregnant or a man is waiting for that promotion or a student is waiting for his results. Now, Stephen Omojuigbe is back with us to talk about how we can effectively utilize this period to our advantage.
Yeah.
Welcome back, boss.
Thank you, Titi. Nice
this is your tour of Nigeria, or is it the tour of the world?
It's a global tour.
Global tour. Well, you're back with us now.
Yes.
We're happy to have you.
Thank you. I'm glad
so
to
this,
be here.
This waiting game, really, why is it so hard for people to just hunker down and wait?
Good question, because we all struggle with it, and it's a biological problem.
Okay.
Every human being has this infantile desire to live like a child, effortless living, not waiting for anything. And it starts from when it was small. The little toddler is in his crib. It feels wet, he yells, mommy comes and dives in like a Superman, changes him and he feels good. He's hungry, he yells, mommy dives in and caregivers just take care of them. So we grow up with all of that logged into our nervous system. The idea that things happen instantaneously. And remember, as a little child, you have children. They feel waiting time is rejection time. So they are hungry, mommy is preparing the meal, but they are yelling because they think mommy does not like them or somebody does not like them.
Also, they're not being listened to.
Yeah, they're not being listened to. So they see waiting as rejection, they see waiting as a refusal. And we carry that into adulthood, a lot of people. It takes a lot of consciousness maturing into the way the real world works for us to understand that there will be seed. there will be time and then there will be harvest. Now, the real world does not work with instant gratification. There is a time for everything. Life works in season, and if you don't understand the seasons of life, you get frustrated. Yeah. Because there will be morning, and then there will be night, and there will be morning again. There will be winter, then there will be fall, there will be springtime, then there will be summer. But the thing is, and this is an encouragement for anyone who is in the waiting period right now, it doesn't matter how long the night is. Some nights could be pretty long. But even in the Antarctic, where the night can be 3 months, morning comes. And so waiting time never lasts forever. Okay. This is the understanding and the idea in your mind that can help you through that waiting period.
You know, there are different types of waiting periods. We mentioned that earlier. You know, for instance, a woman who's pregnant is waiting, you know, for a baby to be born. And, you know, there's so much that happens during a waiting period. But I know that as a life coach, you must have a way you've been able to treat or rather talk to your clients about this waiting period.
I usually talk to them about the three P's of the waiting period. The first one is to pleasure in the wait. Lots of people kind of postpone their joy till when whatever it is they're looking for is manifested. The single people postpone, I will be happy when I get married. So they don't enjoy their single life. Wow. Lots of women, they get pregnant and they don't start to bond and create a relationship with that child immediately. They wait until the child is born. Mm-hmm. They don't enjoy the pregnancy and they miss a lot. So there is a place where you can begin to have some kind of intercourse with that which you're waiting for. I'll tell you a quick story. I remember about 20 years ago, I was dead poor. I was living on the streets. I was working as a driver. Sometimes I work as a conductor. I lived in a room that was completely bare. There was nothing in that room, not a rug, not a carpet, not a bed. It was just one single settee. But I understood, and I'd gotten into this then, I understood that I could begin to have an affair with my future. Visualization is what we call it. So much so that it affects my internal reality. And I remember one day, this is a very true story, I remember one day, I woke up in that room, and for about 2 minutes I was disoriented because I was wondering, what am I doing here? I don't live here. Because in my mind, in my psyche, I was romancing my future. So waiting period is the time to enjoy that which you're looking forward to have intercourse with it, to visualize it, to see it, and then you can have a life of joy even when the thing that you're looking forward to is not manifested. You can, as a single guy, just dream about your wife. You can, as a guy who doesn't have a job, just dream about
your dream job,
and you can have a relationship with that. And the beautiful thing about that is that that actually kind of fast track the manifestation of that which you're waiting for.
Okay, so I want to come from the angle of a woman waiting for, you know, the right man to come along.
Yeah.
You know, she has been waiting and waiting and waiting. In maybe two sentences, what advice would you give to a young lady right now who is waiting for that right man?
Okay, so let me talk about the second P. The second P is about preparation. Waiting period, like winter, is a time to gather strength. It's a time to wait because springtime will come, and springtime is opportunity time. Often, a wait will end with an opportunity. Waits don't ritually end with the thing manifesting. It's an opportunity to manifest the thing. And so waiting time is time for the woman to prepare herself. Of course, enjoy her singleness, but then prepare herself. Prepare herself mentally, emotionally, psychologically, socially. Because the time will come where an opportunity for a relationship that will end in marriage will come. And sometimes you see women who are advanced in age and unmarried, not all of them. And the reason they are in that situation is because they miss those opportunities. Oh. So you have to prepare yourself to be able to recognize the opportunity and to take advantage of it when it comes.
Stephen, is always an enlightening time whenever you come to the studio. Hopefully we've been successfully motivated out there. Stephen always brings something amazing for us to think about. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
All right, and with that, we have to move on with the show. We have a short break coming your way. Don't go anywhere.
Now, VConnect Global Services is an online service marketplace that helps users hire local professionals for all service needs. Vishal, who's also already one of us here at TVC, is also the head of sales at VConnect, and he is here with Usman Abdulghafar Maikudi, the CEO of GAF Maikudi Nigeria, who is going to be telling us about how VConnect has improved his fumigation business. Mr. Maikudi, you are welcome to the show, and Vishal, Thank you so much for joining us this morning as well.
Thank you.
Good morning, sir.
So, you are running
a cleaning
and fumigation business. Yes. And when did you start?
Probably I actually started around 2013.
Okay.
And the kind of business we do is cleaning and fumigation.
Yeah, which is
general cleaning. Yeah.
General cleaning.
Yes,
yeah. So at what point, I mean, you started about 5 years ago, at what point did you come in contact with V-Connect?
Just like after 2 years.
After 2 years, yes. Okay.
And you know, when we started, the kind of customer we are getting it, we are getting at a very low phase. It becomes a business of once in a while.
Yes.
But by the time we started with V-Connect, it becomes on a daily basis business. Because why? If you go to their, they will create a dashboard for you. Mm. So you will access your dashboard. Sometimes they will send you a lead. Mm. You get it on your mail and you get it on your phone as well. Mm. So if you cannot get it, you can go to their market. And because there's a lot of clients waiting for you, you just go to the market and pick anyone, and you send a quotation. So it become, the V-Connect has really helped the business to become on a daily basis, a daily basis business. So we have been very tremendous, and they have been wonderful.
Wow. Okay, so you move from just having a business where people call you when they get your number, definitely, or maybe when somebody refers you,
definitely,
to a marketplace where, you know, anybody anywhere can just reach out to you and say, come do some work for us. Yeah. So tell us about how the dashboard works. So if I'm a standard regular business, how does it work, and how do people get in touch with you and things like that on the platform?
Okay. So how the dashboard works is, you know, the V-Connect, they're online platforms.
Yes.
And you know, when people put to this, if they are not with their laptops, computer, they are with their phones.
Yeah.
So they are online 24/7. And everything is on the goggles. And once people like maybe need any services, maybe they want to clean their house, they want to fumigate their house. Mm. So once they are able to get to V-Connect, they will ask, okay, someone like Gaf Meku Nigeria may offer the business of cleaning and fumigation. And most of the time, V-Connect will send the leads. They will contact the V-Connect. V-Connect will now send the leads to your dashboard.
Right.
So if you're on a dashboard, you can access it.
And so like a standard client can just go there and search for maybe fumigation services in Ikeja.
Yes.
And the number of options will come up.
Definitely.
Okay.
Yes. Definitely.
All right. Excellent.
Sorry, I would want to come in here. So, you know, he mentioned a part where he said market. You go to the market and pick it up.
Yeah.
So, you know, what normally happens is businesses are the one that go to customers, users.
Yeah.
For example, let's say today I'm into fumigation. I'm the one who goes out to search for customers. What we have done at V-Connect is we have created something which is known as market.vconnect.com,
right,
where you have customers waiting for businesses to come and pick them up.
Right.
So that's what he meant by market. So sometimes we send him the leads on his dashboard, whereas sometimes we put it on the market.
Mm.
So if he's sitting idle and he has the bandwidth to take up more jobs, he would just go to the market, pick up the customer he wants to serve, read about the customer, what's the requirement, and call the customer that, okay, I saw your requirement on V-Connect. How can I help you?
Wow, that's amazing.
So that's what he was talking about.
So you can actually then grow your business that way. So if you have the capacity to then take on new business,
exactly,
you just go to the market.
Exactly.
This is absolutely amazing. So if I'm a graphic designer, a programmer, whatever it is, I can continue to expand my business.
Yes,
yes. Partnering with V-Connect is just wonderful.
Wow.
Just wonderful, because with V-Connect, at least you can do your business. And they are very affordable.
Mm.
They are very affordable. They don't charge too much price.
Wow.
And with a little, let's assume, with 400 naira, you can make a million.
That's amazing.
400 naira.
That's
make a million.
That's absolutely amazing. I mean, if you're talking about small businesses, if I'm a small business, it's a no-brainer to just think about, you know, I'm not getting too much business, but once I get on the platform, it's like I'm just open to a new world of people. I'm going to come back to you, Mr. Mekudi. We're going to talk about all the money that you're making. But tell us about this insurance simplified that you have on V-Connect.
Yeah, each week I come, I try to show you where we have reached.
Yeah.
So this is currently a page that we have on vconnect.com. So if you go to vconnect.com/insurance, you come to this page where you have the different insurance. You know, I've been mentioning to you all this while that there are different types of insurance.
Yeah.
So you have life, health, motor, travel, agri, marine, property, accident, fire. So let's say I click.
It keeps expanding, because it started with just four.
Yeah.
But now we have 9 of them.
Okay. Yeah. So on the same page down, if you come, you have our partners, You have the basically the service explained on the whole. So if you come back here and let's say I clicked on motor insurance, mm-hmm. the page opens up like this, and over here is where we say we're going to ask a few questions.
Yeah.
So let's say I clicked on next. We ask you where do you need the insurance service. You click
Lagos.
On next. Yeah. Let's say I need
it. And then it gives you different towns in Lagos. Okay.
Yeah. So now it asks you what type of motor insurance you need. Comprehensive, third party.
Mm-hmm.
I say comprehensive. Then it asks you which insurance cover do you want. So what exactly do you want to cover in mm-hmm. that? You know, in comprehensive. So you want to cover everything.
Yeah.
So whatever you want to cover, you can just mention that here. And then you can go next. How your preferred cover period, 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
Two-wheeler, car, Jeep, SUV. So I can select a car.
Yeah.
How many vehicles do you want to insure? So I select one, and so on and so forth.
And
so
I'm liking the speed of the interface. It just looks like everything is by the click.
There are about total 19 questions.
Yeah.
By the time you fill it, at the end of it, it's just going to ask you for your name, phone number, and email. So naturally, you know, a lot of people and marketing agencies, when they talk to us, they tell us, hey, you have 19 questions.
Yeah.
That's going to take up a whole lot of time to fill.
Yeah.
And, you know, the user might not be interested.
Mm-hmm.
So, I normally tell them, and which is what the statistics also on our platform tells us, is that whenever anyone who's serious comes to the platform and he starts filling the form, he fills it till the end because he needs that job.
Exactly.
And he can vouch for it because he has been getting jobs in fumigation and cleaning. And for him to get jobs, that means even the fumigation or cleaning form is around 8 or 12 questions.
Yeah.
So this is about 19 questions. It doesn't make a difference. If someone can fill 12 questions, he can naturally wait another 1 minute and fill all 19 questions.
Yeah. So if you then fill all these questions, do you get just one quote from the one that's closest to you, or how does
it work? What happens is if I have three companies who want to provide the same service,
mm-hmm.
you get quotes from three. If I have two, you get quotes from two. But we don't normally send it to more than three, because what happens is even as we did a research when we started this, mm-hmm. and we found out, you know, whenever you go to the market to buy something, you might enter one shop, next shop, and by the third one, you make your decision.
Exactly.
Because the first two have given you a rough idea,
mm-hmm.
and then now you choose between the three.
Yeah,
that's the same thing with us. So, you know, most businesses at times they say, okay, you know, we speak to so many customers, but we don't convert them.
Yeah.
So that's because you don't give them a competitive quote, or because you don't handle them properly, the way they're supposed to be handled.
Yeah. Yeah.
For people who stick around with us and who know how to handle customers like Gaf Mekudi and Sons,
mm-hmm.
they are making money.
Yeah.
For him to say that, you know, with 400 naira, that's actually, depending on the service, we charge you a introduction fee.
Yeah.
So that with that amount, you can make as much. We are not concerned whether you make 10 million naira, 1 million naira, 100,000, 50,000. We're just going to charge you that introduction fee.
Hmm.
And that's about it.
Wow. I mean, the VConnect is absolutely the platform to be on, especially for young entrepreneurs, people who you don't have any work you're doing, but you've got a talent. Just develop it, make it into a business, and get on VConnect, and you'll be amazed at the opportunities that are out there. Mr. Mekudi?
Yes.
Amazing. We have many more questions for you, but we're rounding off now. So we're going to talk some more about this fumigation business.
Okay.
That's Gaf Mekudi and Sons.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing. Thank you, Vishal, for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to go on a break now. There's more at the top of the hour on Wake Up Nigeria.
Hello. Once again, we're here bright and early this Monday morning to make sure that you start your day the right way.
It's Monday.
Yes, sir.
The kids are back in school. There's going to be a little bit of traffic today. So if you have anywhere to go, start early.
Yes, indeed.
Very, very important.
And of course, we have something sweet cooking in the kitchen.
Yeah, Mike and Afe already getting things done in there.
I don't know.
We're going to be seeing the final outcome.
What
at
mistake
the end of the day.
Must have happened that they allowed Mike to take over that kitchen this morning? I don't know what happened.
There were 10 snails when this show started.
Yeah, and now
there's like four left. And probably one at the end of the show.
Okay. So, well, hey, if you're wondering our names, my name is Titi Layo Oyinson.
And I'm Yomi Okwe. We're live online right now at tvcontinental.tv and on Facebook. And you can check us out at TVC Connect. For comments, use the hashtag Wake Up Nigeria on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
Yes, indeed.
And amazing week.
Yes.
Already, we already brought you some motivation from Stephen Omojiwe.
It was interesting what he had to say, you know, about waiting. You know, that whole gestation period. It's really interesting. If you missed it, check it out on YouTube. It'll be there soon. Just search for today's date, hashtag Wake Up Nigeria, and you'll find it. Yes, a musical indeed. Performance will be coming your way in a little while from Nigerian Afro-pop artist Bitasha. I like that name.
Yeah.
Bitasha.
And then after that, we have MM coming with one of her crazy life hacks. This time, she will be showing us different possible uses of plastic bottles and ways to recycle them.
Yes, so we're going
green. I'm already seeing
some
funny looking things there. I don't know what she's about to do.
We're going green on Wake Up Nigeria. And hey, we'll finally be having Nigerian actress, OAP, and writer, the one, the only, Oreka Goddess. She'll be right here on the couch for a chat.
Jade, please.
Oh, for the love of God, please let me through.
Jade, please wait. It was all a Are you going to let me talk to you? It was all a misunderstanding, Jade.
Misunderstanding?
Yes.
That's not what Chioma said.
Now forget Chioma, man.
Forget her?
Forget that goody two-shoes. She doesn't know what she's talking about.
Of course.
Can I be honest with you? Are you going to relax for 1 minute so I can be honest with you?
I can do that. Were you naked? Were you
naked? Wow, what a question.
Can I be honest with you? Can I be honest with you?
Leave it off, Ne.
Can I be honest with you right now?
We don't have time.
Mike, another day. Mike, go there.
I would never go there.
Yeah,
straight up. So Serena Williams and all about the controversy and all about. So what do you guys have to say?
Look, I think Serena either needs a break or she needs to retire because she
totally. Let me finish.
Let me finish. Okay, so first of all, Serena had a meltdown on the court on the courts. Over the weekend. And it was because I feel that she was losing the match and she kept getting upset, more and more upset. And all of that. So it now got to, it now peaked at a point where she just absolutely lost
it. She lost it.
Okay, so I feel like the only reason why you use the word meltdown is because she's a woman. That's the only reason why you use the word meltdown.
Donald Trump
has meltdowns
all the time.
She wasn't fighting for her rights. No, okay. She wasn't defending herself. She had a meltdown, really, you know what I mean?
But actually,
Why was it a meltdown?
It actually was a meltdown.
She had a
meltdown. Okay, well, I feel that...
She broke her racket.
Yeah, on...
That's crazy.
Meltdown. Yeah, yesterday, my pastor talked about how to control your emotions. So, if
look. Can you see on the screen how the racket actually broke?
I've seen, I saw Pete Sampras break so many rackets.
Yeah, so if I had this if I had this conversation before the sermon, I would have supported Serena because the truth is, the coach actually reprimanded her on while the game was going on. The umpire, chief umpire Ramos, actually reprimanded her. And then she reacted to it because she's like, this has happened several times.
Yeah.
Why me? Exactly. It was as if there was an attack on her.
Exactly.
Yeah. And she was trying to defend herself.
Exactly.
And yes, she went, she blurted out a few words she shouldn't have.
Of course.
Exactly.
But she was only trying to defend herself as
okay. You know what happened? You know what happened?
She called the umpire a thief
and a liar.
I mean, that's crazy.
It's almost like in football, there is a restricted area for the coach. Almost every coach, even every coach, steps out of that area.
Steps out of the line.
And it's wrong that they don't reprimand you or penalize you. Doesn't mean that it's right.
Exactly.
And so yes, everybody does it. But then she was penalized. Her coach, Patrick Matrulobu, said, "I did try to coach her. She wasn't watching me." Which was wrong, but everybody does it. Doesn't mean it's right. So the umpire was actually, you know, he was doing the right thing.
Exactly.
You know, there was no conspiracy.
I think there is a conspiracy.
It was a meltdown. She has been fined $17,000
and
all that. So
that's a heavy fine.
Look, congrats
if it was anybody else.
Congrats to Naomi Osaka.
That should be the news.
The young
girl, who just, the first Japanese male or female.
She's just an amazing girl. And I think that's why Serena was upset. But anyway, that's fine. That's just me. We have to go to the news now, and IK is on standby for us.
Yummy. Thanks very much, indeed. Now, here's the news update. The Nigerian army says that it has restored normalcy in Gudumbale, that's in Guzamala local government area, Borno State, which was attacked by insurgents on Saturday. In a statement released this Sunday, Director, Army Public Relations, Texas Chukwu, revealed that troops of Operation Lafia Dole repelled the terrorists after a fierce battle that lasted many hours, as their troops are still in pursuit of the fleeing insurgents who have been forced to the fringes of Lake Chad. The army spokesman also noted that additional troops have been deployed to the area. Now, operatives of the police, Federal Special Anti-Robbery Squad in River State have received stern warning to abide by the new regulations guiding their operations. The Federal Special Anti-Robbery Squad is now to limit their operations to tackling armed robbery and kidnapping, though a directive from the State Commissioner of Police may still see the officers venture outside these two areas. The tactical unit has also been barred from setting up stop and search points and getting involved in several matters. According to police committee, charged with the task of overseeing the ongoing overhaul of SARS in the South, severe penalties await any officers who flout these new rules. As part of the branding process, SARS officers will now appear in the outfits that is the original police uniform bearing their name tags. A new uniform for them will be unveiled soon, but because it will take more than changing the officer's appearance for this rebranding to succeed, the committee says every SARS officer will now undergo psychological evaluation. SARS operatives were also warned to desist from involving themselves in politics. The police high command says that it will pay special attention to enforce this directive in view of the 2019 general elections. Well, as the 2019 general elections gather momentum with presidential aspirants reaching out to power blocs across the country, Senate President Bukola Saraki has led the Senate caucus of the People's Democratic Party to Abia State. The team was received by Governor Okezie Igbazo at the Government House in Omuahia. That's the state capital, where Saraki clearly declared his mission is to seek support for his presidential ambition. It says he is driven by a vision to change the nation's fortunes. Well, that's the news update this hour. Thanks very much indeed, Mike, and I beg your pardon. Well, the program continues very shortly. Just stay with us.
Okay, all right. So, we are right here in the kitchen, and the snail is done.
Yes.
Our shrimps are done. Yes. We've already parboiled the pasta.
Yes.
All right, and now this is the sauce.
Bubbling away.
So what next now? I know I would have to work on mixing now. Yeah. What do we do with this sauce now?
Put in the snail. Well,
you put everything. I wanted to confirm that the thing was...
It's complete, don't worry.
Crisps,
it is. Don't worry, calm
crispy
down.
Enough now.
Calm down, it's okay.
We need to do check, NAFDAC check or something.
No, it's okay.
Are you sure?
It's okay.
Very sure?
Very sure.
Not fair now. Okay, so well, it's inside there now. How do we now? This is the
cabbage, carrots.
All right.
So that goes in.
That goes in here.
Yeah. Let's halfway.
Okay, halfway.
Yeah.
Is this good?
Yes, yeah, it's good.
All right.
Then the carrots.
Wow, the carrot halfway too.
Yeah, halfway too.
Okay.
So it'll be easier for you to stir. Yeah.
Great one. Is this good?
Yeah. That's
all right.
Good.
Woo.
So stir it. Stir it.
My skills are showing, man.
Stay up.
Hey.
Stay up.
My skills are showing. Are you seeing this?
Stay up.
Ha! My skills are showing, man.
Why are you doing that? I'm putting in the shrimp.
Okay. Wow, this is the real sous chef. MM and Titi and Mary, are you learning from me? Look at, are you seeing this? MM, are you seeing this? Titi, are you seeing this? You all could learn one or two things from my expertise in culinary matters, you know? Okay, so
the shrimps.
I wanted to say prawns. Shrimps have gone in there.
Yep.
Wow, that's looking so nice.
Told you I would convert you.
It's looking nice, but we have to confirm that it's tasting nice. We have to ensure taste is okay.
Wait till you are called to the dining table.
No, not yet. Okay, so while this is going on, what else we put into this?
Now the remaining cabbage and carrots.
We're putting all.
So it'll be easy for you to mix in.
I was thinking I'll take some home. this is okay now. This is not too big now, you know. My skills are telling me that this is okay. Okay, all right.
Yeah,
so
more
carrots. Carrots is plenty.
Put all.
Are you put all?
Put all.
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 All. All. All.
All. All. All. Put all. You want to go and make shawarma?
I put all, but not all, all.
All. Oh, yeah, stay.
You see now, because it's too much now.
It's not too much.
It's too much inside this this place.
Maybe you want to walk, but yeah, stare.
It's too much. See. See now, this one is not enough. Let me put this one.
See? Told you, put all.
This one can put all, but that carrot.
Can you handle the quantity to stay?
Hey! Mm-hmm. A whole handler like me. Have you seen handler? Do you know I will handle anything?
Anything.
Wow, this is a masterpiece in stirring or mixing or whatever you want to call it. Okay, so, all right. Yeah. So, let's. What else do we need to do?
That's
what else we need
all.
To do? Let's, that's all, right?
Yeah, then I put in the green pepper and we're done.
Oh, we're done. Yep. Wow, woo. That's cool. That's cool. Yeah. All right. Okay, all right, so we're done. And it's quite a lot. Where does this come in?
In there.
In there. Do I put it now?
Yes, but you need to get another spoon because that's.
Yes, this one is. This one, which. What type?
Maybe a proper cooking spoon.
A proper cooking
maybe
spoon?
Maybe that one hanging there.
This one?
Yeah.
Ah, I knew fine. I knew it was this one I was going to use. I just need to...
You wanted to be sure.
Second opinion. Yeah, no, it's called second opinion.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. I get it washed and clean. Yeah. Make sure, you know, so when you get out your spoon, make sure you always wash your spoon like I just, you know, make sure it's clean and neat and all that. Yeah. So we put this one, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Like a full spoon.
It's not like I don't know.
So why are you asking?
It's called second opinion. Okay. Have you not seen when experts used to meet an expert?
If you ask questions, you will not get lost too.
Okay. Just ask. All right. So while we're getting all of this done, MM is on standby. We spoke about that DIY much earlier. She's ready. MM, what do you have for us?
All right. Thank you very much, Mike, the chef. Okay. So today on Life Hacks, I'll teach you a few various ways to reuse your plastic bottles and also save some money. So first of all, I'll be teaching you on how to use your plastic cup to keep using your plastic bottles to keep your teacups. So, okay, so first of all, I'm going to be working here with a bigger plastic bottle, as you can see here. So I had already cut off the top of the bottle, and then this is the half part of it. So earlier on, I actually cut up a part of it here, so I'm just going to complete it all the way down. So what you do, I'm going to be working, of course, with, you know, your scissors. And if you'd like, you could use, you know, gloves. It depends on how you like to work with your hands. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to cut off a part of this plastic bottle. Make sure you do this carefully because you do not want to overdo it. Overcut it, I mean. So this plastic bottle actually is basically, it's quite thick compared to other plastic bottles. So we have different types of plastic bottles, basically. So what I'm going to do here is I have my teacups. I'm just going to stack them one after the other. So you have the handles sticking out of the part you already cut off your plastic bottle. So you just layer them on neatly, as you can see here, and there you go. So you can do this to as many teacups as you want, but that way you have, your plastic bottle has to be, you know, way, you know, bigger than this, or, you know, it depends on how you want to stack up your teacups. So that's that for this. The next one I'll be showing you basically is, okay, so what I did here is I have two plastic bottles. The top of the plastic bottle, these are smaller plastic bottles that I have cut open. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm just storing my binder clips. So you could basically store anything in smaller pieces in this kind of, you know, piece here. So you could put this in your office if you like. You could, you know, even store little chocolates if you like into this. And what you just do is just open it up and just bring it out. And here you go, very easy. So instead of throwing out your empty bottles, yes, your empty plastic bottles, there's so many other things you could do with it. So another one I'm gonna show you is basically how to, another way you could reuse your plastic bottles is, you know, planting. You could use it to plant. You could use it in storing your pens, your pencils, and even your makeup brush. you know, for those of us who like to make use of our make-it story. So there are so many ways to reuse your plastic bottles instead of throwing them away. Let us help save the environment and keep it healthy. So save your plastic bottles and find ways to reuse them that'll be useful for, you know, you and everyone around you, right? Great stuff. All right, so there's more on Wake Up Nigeria. Stay with us.
And here's that performance we promised you. I've got Bless in the house, a.k.a. B. Tasha. How you doing?
I'm okay. I'm
you
fine.
Look nice.
Thank
All right,
you.
She's an Afropop singer and also a humanitarian. I like that. Right, but they're about to drop it for us, right?
Yeah.
Look like you're ready.
Yeah,
should I just join these guys? Where they are now? Should just start and let me just join. Let's go. But I'm out. Okay, so now something quite interesting. You okay. spoke about also having to or being involved with an NGO you yeah. started. Tell me a bit about that.
Okay, so Delta Picking Initiative is actually aimed to empower and also advocate for children in Delta State, you understand?
Yeah, okay.
So, yeah.
All right, you want to catch your breath, right?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. because that was a very energetic performance and all of that. That song is titled
Kudoko.
Okay, let's talk about what inspired that song.
Okay, so the thing is, I was actually trying to relate a situation where you have a girl that's in love with a guy and wants to keep a relationship like so private that she doesn't want any. Yeah.
You want to put it out there.
Yeah.
So did you believe in putting relationships out there, or do you think it should be low key?
Well, I think it should be low key. It's better.
Ah. Like, if you don't tell the world, then that means that you are being funny, like you might be running things somewhere or something like that.
Not really, because at the end of the day, if it's out there, like a whole lot of stuff start coming in, and so just to avoid those drama, for me, I would want to have like a very private relationship.
My type of person. All right, so do you have a body of work out there? An album or something? You have something
okay,
out there?
So the thing is, I'm currently working on a project.
Yeah, okay.
So my video is coming out very soon.
Oh,
then
okay.
Also for my NGO next month, we are starting a project called Project Tell for single mothers. So basically, the idea is Project Tell is just actually to make single mothers feel special and also let them know that they can also engage themselves in a skill. Do you understand? So.
Oh, all right, cool. I'm looking forward to that. So next month for Project Tell,
yes.
And the album, like when?
Before the end of the year.
All right, but then video is coming out quite soon. I'm looking out for that, Bitasha. It was great having you. Thank you so much. You guys, I'm better than you guys. So. All right, but then thank you very much, guys. Let's head over to Yomi and Titi. They'll be taking us on happenings or events this week in history.
All right, welcome Mike and Bitasha. It's time for This Week in History. We have very, very little time for that, but we'll try and get past as many as possible, starting with September 11.
Yes, indeed. September 11, 2001, a series of four coordinated suicide attacks were carried out by a terrorist group, Al-Qaeda. 19 militants, four California-bound airplanes from the East Coast cities in the U.S., they used these planes to target major American landmarks. Two planes crashed into the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center and caused them to collapse within 2 hours of being struck. One plane was crashed into the Pentagon building, while the fourth plane, thought to be bound towards Washington, D.C., crashed into a field in Pennsylvania after the passengers tried to fight back against the hijackers. The attacks claimed the lives of about 3,000 people, destroyed property worth billions of dollars, and the attack was the precursor to the war against terror in Afghanistan.
Really, really. I mean, that singular attack changed the world as we knew it from 2001 up till date, and it's been one fight after the other. New terrorist groups have emerged, have sprung up since then.
Cells coming out of different, you know.
All right,
and then,
so
of course,
we have
the
to,
airports have all changed all their security measures and so much more.
And that was one attack that caused it all. But we're moving to the next one now. Mungo Park. Who remembers Mungo Park in our history? Well, he was born this week in history, and he was a Scottish explorer of West Africa. He was the first Westerner known to have traveled to the central portion of the River Niger, and his account of his travels is still in print. Hostile natives who attacked his travel party with bows and arrows, throwing spears. Their position being untenable, Park, his assistant, Martin, and the two remaining soldiers sprang into the river and were drowned near Yauri local government, which is in Kebbi State today. And the location of the Yauri Emirate, one of the historical landmarks.
Yeah, of course.
Amazing. That's how he died.
Yeah, that's how he died. But he went, I was going through his travels, and he went straight across West Africa. He was trying to find the source of
Why would a man do that? I mean, those guys are crazy. But anyway, that's Mungo Park. He was born this week in history.
Yes, indeed. 1771. Now, Taraji P. Henson was born this week in history on September 12th, 1970. I didn't know she was this old until I started searching
Almost
out.
Almost 50.
Yes, indeed. Now, she's an international, American international actress. And she started out by playing the mother of a disabled child in David Fincher's The Curious Case of Benjamin Button. Now, that was an amazing movie in 2008. And she received an Academy Award, a SAG Award, Critics' Choice Award nomination for that role as Best Supporting Actress. Now, in January 2016, she won the Golden Globe for Best Actress in a television series drama for Empire, the third African-American actress to take home that award.
Yeah, anybody that remembers Cookie Lyons.
Let's see her in action. Oh, now you can't speak English. You about to break yourself.
Okay, lady, we know you got connections and I know you got juice. That's why I know you had something to do with my...
Anyway, we don't have that much time. But yeah, but remember Barry White, who was born this week in history, September 21st. Well, that's actually next week.
12th. It's actually 12th.
12th, September 12th. Yeah. That's tomorrow as well. Born this week in history. You say once I'm with you, I'll never go back. You say there's a lesson that you want to teach. Well, here I am, baby. Practice what you... Hey, woo! Barry White.
Practice
how can
what
you be
you
playing
preach?
Barry White at 8:30 in the morning, Titi? Well, like, I don't understand.
Hey. I can't get enough of your love and so many other great hits from Barry White.
Anyway, that's This Week in History with that Barry White feel. We're sorry, but, you know, we just had to do it. We have to go on a break now. When we get back, we're going to be here with our record goddess. Welcome back. Now, our next guest is a woman. Yes, she's a woman. She has no compunctions about being whoever she is and expressing herself. And she's an actor, a broadcaster, producer, writer.
And so much
fashionista, because we've been on her Instagram and we've seen what she's been up to lately.
You're stalking her already?
Yes,
calm
I
down
am.
Now.
I'm going to send you a DM in a bit.
Really? This delectable personality is none other than Oreka Goddess. Now, she can be described as a storyteller. She uses many media to tell her stories. And of course, she's a communicator. She likes to communicate some messages. Even if it's just with a look, she'll tell you what she's thinking. How's it going, Oreka?
I am so excited to be here. I have been wanting to be here for a while. So thank you for inviting me.
So what time did you wake up this morning?
Just before 5.
Okay.
And I said I was excited to come. Like, no. I must be, as they're opening their gates, I must be there.
Okay, so there's so much about you that, you know, a lot of people probably don't know how you started, educational background and all that. But once you appeared on the media scene, everybody noticed that you were there. You are different. What was it, you know, in your opinion, that made you stand out in the very beginning?
I don't know. I know that when I first started on radio, I used to get hate mail, is what I call it.
No.
Like the first 3 or 6 months was just, why do you sound like that? What's this, your format? I don't like the format. What's this, you know? And I was just getting on. And for me, I took that on board. I took that to heart.
Okay.
Because I always put myself in the position of the person who's watching or listening. Mm. And if they feel like they're not connecting with me, then I'm already alienating whoever it is I'm trying to, you know, do the service for. And so I then had to, okay, yes, you just got back, but you don't need to sound like you just got back. Okay.
So how are you supposed to sound?
So I started, I would literally leave the job and go home and I'll stand in front of the mirror and say certain words and just try to sound more... or rather, less like, you know, I just got back, you know, what's good. Because it's annoying.
Yeah.
And then I would listen to a lot of my recordings as well and just, okay, yeah, I can see. I would annoy me if I had to listen to that.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So I'm not saying that other people didn't do that, but maybe that made a difference. I don't know.
Okay, maybe it was about working on yourself, maybe.
Definitely.
Possibly. And one of the things that I know that you're big at is also, I think, being very introspective so that you can understand what people want or what people are going through. How do you pick your topics when you want to deal with people or talk, you know, on your shows?
I think people pick me. And then the topics find me in that way.
Okay.
I get messages from people, either an email or text or whatever it is. And I mean, there's a show that I've been working on now, Love Lounge, where there isn't a single day that I don't get stopped by somebody who would, some people share the most explicit things about their lives.
I can imagine.
And I'm like, I'm very grateful that you trust me with this information. But the weight of it is too much.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, and so the topics come from there, essentially. I think the more open you are to people and the more they feel that they can trust you with parts of their lives, they just tend to share more. Or maybe I have a trusting face. So
okay.
Trust me
face.
With your money.
Maybe.
I think it's the face.
The millions, the dollars, the yen. Trust me with it.
All right. Look at that photograph up there.
Yeah,
if I saw
that,
I'd like to tell her my life history.
Yes, indeed.
And just...
But it's interesting you should mention Love Lounge, because the topics that have been discussed on Love Lounge have gone into areas of, you know, I don't know how to describe it without becoming vulgar.
I don't know how to describe it, and it's a show I do.
Yeah. But then has it actually molded the way you see relationships? You know, there was a very open, like, public relationship that it's all over online, you know, and has that actually sort of shaped how you look for a new man or, you know, work with your relationships?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Mm. I didn't know about love language, for instance, before Love Lounge. I mean, I knew it existed, but I never really cared. I was like, that's so self-help. I don't want it, you know. Okay. I never really thought that much about how communication is important in relationships because I just assumed we all talk, yes, but we don't necessarily listen. And sometimes we listen, but we're not hearing each other. And sometimes we're communicating the way that we think works for us, but it doesn't work for the person you care about. Yeah. And so you're getting into fights because you're saying, we keep fighting over the same thing. And you're thinking, we keep talking about this. Yeah, but you're not, you know? Yeah. So it definitely has shaped the way I, and not just relationship with the opposite sex, but even with my family members and friends and colleagues, I'm more, hopefully, I think, a little bit more aware and more careful about how I you know, take into other people's considerations.
Yeah, but this awareness, does it also help you not judge people? Because sometimes, you know, when maybe two people are in a relationship, it's easy for you to judge when somebody takes a certain step in a certain direction based on maybe their background or something that they've been through before. Mm-hmm. So what do you think?
I find that judgment comes from a place where you don't understand the person and where some people turn it into hate or fear or whatever it is. It's easier to just judge, how dare she, I would never. Mm-hmm. But you're not in that person's shoes. You don't know what they're thinking. So how about you try and find out what's going on before you judge? And so that's another thing I learned, yeah.
Okay, so I want to ask specifically about some of the very explicit things you have said about your own relationships on TV. Yes, wow. On TV. So. Now, I would be, first of all, thinking about my family, like, oh my God, what are they going to say? And sometimes I code, even the producers are like, let's go now.
Yeah.
But how have you been able to manage that, family and all?
So when I first got told that I was going to be doing this show, I was going to turn it down because I said, you want me to talk about what? Where? With lights and cameras on? No, it's not possible. And I had this fear of being seen as that girl who talks about
that.
Yeah.
Yes. And I said, no, I called my sister who is, I mean, nobody loves Jesus like her, let's put it that way. And she said to me that it's a job. And through you, you might be speaking to somebody or reaching to somebody who has no one else to talk to about these things. And through you, they might understand things that range from domestic abuse to even bodily functions, because not all of us went to school, and not all of us that went to school even paid attention in biology class. So. Even as women, there are parts of our bodies that we don't know, we don't understand. There are mothers who you meet sometimes and they'll tell you that my child is doing X, Y, Z and my hormones are reacting this way and they think it's horrible. Yeah. And like, no, it's normal. So my sister sat me down and she said, you have to do this. Okay. And I said, but it'll be explicit. She said, uh-huh. So wow. I called my mom and my mom then gave me a number for one of my aunts who apparently had a radio show back in the 70s in Oyo State that was essentially Love Lounge.
Okay.
And he said, why are you afraid? I said, okay, no problem. Okay.
So we want to do some rapid questions, but we've not even talked about your acting career.
Oh, okay. I think you should answer these questions as quickly as possible.
Okay. Okay, so rapid questions.
Don't think about it. No thoughts about it. Just answer.
I mean, some of them are a bit corny, but we'll just do them.
Uh-oh.
So, white man or black man?
Oh.
Don't think.
Is there...
Don't think.
It's not either or.
Really?
It really isn't.
Both?
Mixed? Both. I've dated the whole range of the spectrum.
Okay, of the spectrum.
Yes.
Wow. I like that. That's
it's supposed
that's
to be rapid, answer. You know what I mean?
Okay. Nigerian jollof or Ghanaian jollof?
I don't like jollof.
Okay, next.
Poor and faithful, rich and anyhow.
Mm. I'm sorry. Poor help.
Wow. Okay, it's still rapid.
Brains or brawn?
Let me break that down now.
No, you can't break it down.
Brains, definitely.
Brains. Okay. Yeah. TV or radio?
Oh.
Hard one.
Don't think. No, you answer that one.
Why?
Yes.
Yeah, you answer.
You answer that one.
Both.
See?
Morning person or night person?
Don't think. Just answer.
It depends on what my life needs at the time. Okay. When I'm doing a breakfast show, I am up first thing. When I'm doing
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, so keeping in shape, exercise or portion control?
exercise.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. I eat a lot.
Okay.
A lot.
Okay.
I've been watching you cook scenes.
Okay, so what's your favorite decade? 70s, 80s, 50s. 90s. Oh, 50s.
Ooh. Yeah. Love the clothes, okay. The music, even the movies, the romance. Yeah. Yeah, love it, love it.
Aww. Okay. Gold or silver?
Silver.
Really?
Yeah.
For real?
Yeah, I don't
Why?
Because it doesn't shine as much as gold.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say all that glitters or something.
Oh, okay.
biggest addiction?
Food. Food. You can take away my internet, you can take away my Instagram. Okay, so but my food
based on that. Addiction to food is what is going to make us take you to the kitchen.
Okay.
Please.
I've been waiting.
Let's go.
Just when it was getting interesting.
Okay. Now your meeting, this is where you're quiet.
Really?
Oreka, please.
Somebody made a mistake and put a mic in the kitchen. I don't know what happened.
Take you look lovely, by the way.
Thank you.
This is beautiful.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay. Are you good?
So, I'm trying to jump into the food, but
don't worry,
at the same
time.
All right. Thank you. Okay. Calm down. Okay. Calm down. All right. Now, this is Chef Ofe, and we had this prepared for you. Tell us, how did we get to this?
Okay.
We did it.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Why are you stampeding her?
Go ahead. All right.
My guys are bullying me. So this is pasta macaroni, and this is shrimp and snail sauce, and this is just a simple slaw, carrots, cabbage, then dressing.
Ooh, please bring that food closer.
Amazing.
Bring it closer.
Quickly.
I mean, you had me at seafood.
Oh. Okay.
So you can start anywhere.
Please, anywhere. Mm. All right, so with that, please tell us how it tastes.
Yeah.
But we'll be wrapping up the show
as
right
a sugary babe.
Now.
We don't need that.
We have to give a big shout out to our friends at Homely NG for the kitchen accessories.
Yeah, of course, and for last place for
the hairstyling.
Whatever he does.
Really? Yummy? Because you refuse to jerry curl your hair.
I'm still going to do it, Fala. Don't worry. I'm going to get that hair done.
And we will be back again tomorrow.
Tuesday,
nice of you to join us, Oreka.
This food is lovely, man.
Thanks, Oreka.
It is gorgeous. You like it?
Have a great day, people.
Like the herbs, it's all fresh.